in class, part two, or also part one, as you like. So we start with stretching our hip, and we start in Virasana. We sit between our heels. You can use a block for this, or two. Lift up your spine and then shake off first a little bit your shoulders and your sacrum and your face. And then from here we slowly move into that position. Back to straighten our hips. So you have to make sure this movement doesn't hurt your lower spine. Therefore, it's extremely important to stretch your hips, make it active, specifically if you don't have enough space in your body. You need to stay active to push up your pubic bone, like into the direction of your nose, to make sure you are not landing in your lower back. Yeah. So if you go back, before you go back, you lift your sacrum and you turn it up to the knees and as up as you can. The opposite of the cow position is cat. So you bring your sacrum in this cat position. Great length in your lower back spine. And we go back. So maybe you need here two bolsters or three, or you don't need any bolster and block at all. So you do what you need. So maybe in the beginning your knees come a little up, yeah? So let them up. This is like in downward facing dog. In the beginning our heels are up, yeah? So again, make sure you lengthen your lower spine by turning your sacrum forward and up, yeah? To be active, to be in this stretch out of your hips, in the front, into your legs, in the front side of your legs. If you need more bolster at home, you can choose any pillows you have, or maybe this posture is easy for you, and you just don't use any bolster, any block. If you start feeling comfortable in it, place your arms behind you. Maybe you grab your upper arms. And you go like this and breathe through your front side. So feel all this body side, this front body side. And open this breath. Relax your face. Stay again as soft as possible. If this is too intense for you, you can also help yourself a little bit by placing your hands on your feet and pushing yourself out a little bit to keep the length in your lower spine, like this. Or you choose to have a higher bolster. It's easier if you have a higher bolster. You can also practice this your upper body on your sofa. Wherever you are, bring the focus to your breaths. Breath by breath, we release that tension by visualizing these spots in our system and allow them to release. Stay in your mind and in your breathing as soft as you can. Here you feel the stretch in your legs, in your upper legs, the front side of your legs, out of your hips. It starts with straightening arms. This might be a difficult movement for you. And also, if it goes deep in these stretches in our system to release all the tension, you might feel different emotions coming up. And sometimes we are certainly in a moment when we were in our childhood. And maybe there was a moment you felt insecure. And because of that, something in your system has closed. And while we are in those deep stretches, sometimes your body reminds these moments. And if you are in one of those moments, like, yeah, if you have it, yes, that's why I was falling from the swing and hurt myself. And if you, this is just an example, and if you are in that state, you can basically help to, if you crack it mentally, you can help to crack it physically in your body to release that old tension, which was manifested maybe by an emotional thing or by a mental thing. If someone, for example, really disappointed you, explore your system, your body, and free your mind and your body. And beside all the tension you feel here, stay soft. How to open it, how to get over it, and if you have that story, if you have found it in your past, what closed up or what was causing this tension in your body, if you found or if you find these stories, say to yourself, thank you. And you can say to your system, it's over. I'm over it. You can release this tension. it to you. We're saying this to you. And also forgive yourself because you were holding all those years this tension in your body, in your system, and in your mind. Five deep breathings. Before we get out of this pose, get active again and stretch left and right. Try to move a little bit. And the easiest way to get out of this pose is to just pull up your legs like this and shake them off. We remove the block, roll up to our chest. If you have a different way, you can do it. Yes? Make sure you take yourself time, help yourself up for this. And come to a seated position. Shake our legs off. So we go in a position to find a counter pose. You come on your knees. You can actually, if you have a bolster, can leave it here, because we go to Anahata Asana, or you remove it. You can do what you like. Sometimes it's nice maybe to have a little blanket prepared, so you can drop your chest bone on this blanket, if you can. So we go slow. So we keep our buttocks above our knees, and then you can place your chest like this. Shift your sacrum and your buttocks up and backwards. And enjoy now the bending in your hips after stretching them or straightening them. You can also place your forehead . Make sure your neck stays relaxed and you have legs, your spine. You can navigate your sacrum to the left and to the right a little bit. And allow your chest to open, your shoulders to stretch out of your chest, into your shoulders, into your hands. And also, it's a stretch through your whole spine, up to your sacrum or to your buttocks. If it is possible, keep your arms long. Shift your shoulder blades back and it will straighten your shoulders. Take a big stretch out of your chest into your shoulders. turn your hands to stretch out in the inner side of our arms into our shoulders. Along our neck. And slightly shift your weight forward and back. And finally sit on your heels. Straighten your spine, lift your arms, steepen the head here, and exhale. So we change the position. We go into Gomukh Asana, and we start with our right leg behind the left leg. So we cross our legs, I don't know if you can see it, we cross our legs, our knees, and sit again between our heels. If this is a difficult movement for you, you can sit a little higher, for example, on a pillow or on a block. If you have a block, you can use a block, like I do now. Yeah? So is that left leg is up, right leg is down. Now we drop the knees and sit as centered as possible with a straight spine and relax out of the hips into our legs. Open your arms. So we place now the right arm. It's a similar position in our arms, then in our legs. So we place the right arm over the left, and now you grab with your left hand into your right hand. So make sure you have your elbows crossed. So now pull down your shoulder blades, lift your chest, your neck, up into the crown of your head. And stay here. Close your eyes and bring the focus in your breathing. So if you feel no stretch, if this is easy for you, remove the block anyway. Take a full body stretch, stretching out of your lower body, out of your hips, into your legs, keeping your spine straight, lengthen your spine with ease, stay soft, and then there's the stretch out of your upper body, into your shoulders, into your arms. If you feel any tension in your neck, you can start to move it from side to release the tension. Keep your spine straight with ease. Let it flow up. push them out of your shoulders. Turn to your left side. You can place your left hand and your right on your right hip or just behind you. Try what you can do. And your right arm is on your left. Lengthen your spine slowly and softly. Move into this twist. And find your center again. So the crown of your head is above your sacrum. Imagine you sit in this pose. On like a very thin strap. And find this balance. Sitting on the thin strap. So what I want to say is find your center and then release again all the tension here you feel with ease and flow out and create space for this movement. Also in your face. Last deep inhale, exhale slowly, come out of this twist, shake off your shoulders, and the last version in this position is a forward bend. So if you have created more space already, and you still sit on a block, maybe you can remove the block. Or if you sit on two blocks, maybe you remove one block. Whatever you feel like. And now we go into this forward bend. And stay here. Go ahead, if you are flexible here, you can drop your elbows or maybe your forehead. Without any expectations, just go to this edge where you are and find softness here in your body and allow this tension to release. Slowly, the awareness in your spine. Get out of this movement. Change our legs. So before you change your legs, go for 3-4 times as much as you need in a cat-cow position. Mobilize your hips, your spine. Left leg behind the right leg, and again we sit between our heels. And if you need, you sit on something like a bolster or a pillow or on a block if you have, and make sure you lengthen your spine, sit up as centered as possible. Lift your arms, deep inhale. Exhale. So we start with our arms, left arm goes over the right arm. Right hand goes into left hand. And first, get active in your neck, create some length and some space here. Lift your chest. Pull your shoulder blades down. Find your position, close your eyes and breathe. Maybe you find a difference on this body side again. So if this side is harder for you, the more you need to help this side to release the tension. Stay focused on your breath. And in your mind, you are as soft as possible. It might be in a very hard pose for you, very intense. Maybe not, maybe it's super easy for you and you ask yourself, where should it stretch? I don't feel anything. That's also right. We are individual, we are different. For somebody this is easy. For some bodies is it very intense. These stretches in your outside of the legs, the more the meridians out here, out of your hip into your legs. And this twist also opens again our right side, our shoulders and neck. It can be intense, also emotion. Because some emotions may come up telling you, I want to get out of this pose. Stay soft and breathe. And explore again a new field, a new side in you. A new yin. Last inhale, slowly exhale, come forward, release your shoulders and your arms, and last but not least, in this position, the Gomukhasana position, forward bend. So if you have already more space, if you feel more space and you are still sitting on something, you may remove this block or pillow. Do as you can. Or stay where you are. If this forward bend is too intense for you now. If you have the space, feel free to come down on your elbows. This side is for my body harder than the other side. Always good to have some props around, to use them if needed. slowly come up. Open up for a moment. Straighten up your spine. Inhale. And then exhale, go out of this pause into a 4-foot stand again. Go and cat cow for a couple of times to move your hips, your lower spine. And for one moment, we get active into a downward facing dog. Place your hands, spread your fingers wide, straighten your arms. Come slowly up. You can bend one knee, lift up one heel, straighten your left leg first. Left heel and straighten your right leg. And both legs. If you need, bend both knees a little bit, and if you need, lift both heels. Shake off your neck, your lips. Down on your knees, add up your lower arms and your elbows. Walk your knees back and place your hips into your Sphinx position. Shake off your lower back, your butt. And lengthen your legs, your spine. Place your elbows under your shoulders. You can place your hands or you can leave them like this. Do what feels comfortable for you and make sure you are out of your shoulders and your neck is relaxed and stay in this Sphinx for a moment to release and to open. Again, the front side in your body, like a Sphinx. So you let drop your pubic bone. And you sit. Relax your spine, your lower spine is relaxed. Just find length between your vertebrae, length out of your hips into your feet. And again, stay as soft as possible. Slowly move your neck from one to the other side, where you can roll it. Chest, create space in your chest, expand in that area of your chest and your heart, energy, anahata, energy again, anahata chakra, your heart energy, expand in this area of your heart, chest, even your lungs. Feel the movement of your breath. Make sure you don't fall into your shoulders. Last deep inhale. And before we go out, I have to say, if you feel very easy in that pose, you can lift up more. Yeah, you can lift up your elbows like this. Yeah? And if you still feel flexible in your spine, you can go up and up and up again, but listen in your spine, how far can you open today? Go with ease and no rush. So, slowly we go out of this position. First, we place our forehead and relax our lower back again, our legs. Bring your left knee up. Open your arms to the side and place your head on your left ear. Relax out of your left side into your left hip and leg. And feel free to stretch this leg out. Maybe you want to have a bigger stretch in your inner leg side. Can do it. Walk it up as high as you can, as high as your legs are possible. So make sure again that your lower leg is totally relaxed. If you feel more comfortable, you can place your head on your right ear. Shake your lower back. We change the side.
Bring your right leg up. Bend it. It's like a half frog. Shift out of your shoulders here. And place your head on your right side first. It's like a little twist. Relax out of your right side, right hip into your right leg. You can embrace the earth round where you're lying on. Maybe you are practicing outside, you can feel the beat of the earth or the warmth if the sun was heating the earth up. Maybe you practice in your living room and you see, oh, I could maybe clean my floor a little bit, whatever. Keep with your mind, go back into your body, into your breathing. We are almost done. So we change the position of our head and feel free to stretch out this right leg as well. You can walk up a little bit with your right foot. Release out of your right hip into the inner side of your right leg. I love this stretch. I could stay here forever and ever, ever, ever. And slowly, if you have your right leg straight, bend it first and move it back. So you still lie on your stomach, shake off as comfortable as possible. And then come up on your knees, and last but not least, our last pose for this sequence is Baddha Konasana. You can use again bolster. You don't have to, you can practice it on the floor. If you like to open up your chest, it's nice to have something to lay on. And before, it's again important to make sure you have no compression in your lower spine, your lower back. So you need to push your sacrum forward again and a little up. Yeah? And maybe you go a little, you leave some space from the bolster. So you choose how far you shift your weight forward. So we are centered here, place the middle of our body in the middle of this polster. Open out of your chest, into your hands. Maybe you need a block behind your head, use it, or another pillow. Use whatever is necessary for you to stay soft, yeah, and to create space to expand. Padmasana, relax out of the middle of your body to the side, out of your chest and out of your lower arm, of our pelvis, out of our hips, into our legs. It might be easy for you. It might be intense or challenging. If you have issues in your hips, it might help or it can help that you stop the movement before you hurt your hip or stress your hip. Yeah? Just stop the movement with the block. The further you go out, then the more it is easy. Yeah? Or you choose the lower side. So choose what you need. Maybe you don't need anything, maybe you do need some props. If you're comfortable, bring the focus again into your breathing and allow this movement, this opening. Also relax out of the middle of your face, into your right and left face parts, and also out of your head, into your right and into your left side of your head. Release out of the third eye, to the side. If you feel tension in your head here, in your forehead, in your eyes, it might help to have a little massage with your fingertips. From the side, from the third eye, from this middle of your forehead, above your nose. And you just go like this. You can continue this movement going like this to activate your lymphatic system here as well. By massaging and helping to expand here and release. And you can always go to that Scheitelpunkt. Unfortunately, I don't know the word in English. So you keep moving to that point where my
Sahasrara chakra. It's the gate to the universe energy, or the cosmic energy. And slowly move your feet, your toes, place your toes, and slowly close your legs first. Shake them out a little bit. Roll up and round your spine into a cat position here. Hug your knees. Come up and go for Shavasana. If you have a bolster, you may like it if you place it behind or below your lower legs. You don't have to, you can try it. It might help you to relax your lower spine a bit more in Shavasana. Find the comfortable position. Make sure your shoulders are relaxed and have space, and your neck is maximum relaxed. Your head is relaxed. Your face, your eyes, your cheeks, your lips are relaxed and as soft as possible. Imagine lying on a flying carpet. And you let yourself fall into this flying carpet. At the same time, you're carried by this carpet. Just imagine these energies between falling and carrying. And you are exactly in the middle. You are like lying on the water, floating. Channels to this outer space, what surrounds you. It's massive, the outer space, with no borders.
doesn't serve you anymore. And create space. For the things you want to go, you want to be. And for the things who do serve you, whatever it is, your dreams, higher goals, your vision, so you can extend your shavasana. If you do so, just stay in your flow. If you want to come back with me, start moving your fingers and your feet, or maybe your face. And begin to breathe a little deeper and get a bit more active in your joints. sound OM. One more deep inhale. We are enough.